What's up, you guys? Welcome back. Today, I'm super excited because we're gonna be doing a full face of dupes. These are some of my favorite videos to film. If you guys haven't watched like my full face of dupes videos, basically I do one half of my face with expensive high-end makeup, and then I do the other half of my face with way more affordable dupe products. So products that basically work just as well as the high-end equivalent, but they're way cheaper. And we see how they compare next to each other. And in today's video as well, I'm also gonna do a wear test, which is something that I haven't done in like my prior full face of dupes videos, but I feel it's also important to show how the products wear throughout the day against each other as well. So I'm really, really excited. I have so many good products to put to the test against each other today. Some of these I've already tested, so I know they're dupes and you guys are gonna love them. And then some of them we're gonna be testing together in today's video because I haven't put them against each other. So I'm super excited. Be sure to subscribe to my channel if you guys have not already and click the little bell right next to the subscribe button so you can be notified of all my future uploads. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. All right, for our first dupe, we're gonna jump in with primer. And this one I am really excited about. I haven't put these to the test next to each other yet, but I feel like they're gonna be really good dupes. So I'm gonna do high end on this side of my face, drugstore on this side of my face. So the high end product we have is the Charlotte Tilbury Wonder Glow. This is $55. It is a really pretty product, but I mean for $55, it should be. So I'm going to put some of this on my skin. It basically just gives like a pretty radiant glow to your skin. It's nothing crazy, more on the natural side, but it is beautiful. I'm just gonna use this little Makeup Forever sponge to blend it out. We'll be using different tools on the different sides of our face just so nothing is contaminated. But it really just morphs into the skin well. It's nice as a primer underneath foundation or like a BB cream or a CC cream to give you a little glow. But Believe Beauty, their radiantly primed face primer works super similarly. This is $5. You can get Believe Beauty at Dollar General. And it is $50 cheaper. Like literally, I don't know, like so much cheaper. And I feel like gives the same look to the skin. So that's what I like to see. On the more affordable side, I'm gonna go with the Eco Tools little sponge. I love this. You can get it off Amazon. It's super affordable. And I'm gonna blend that in. Yeah, like see? This one blends super easily into the skin too. It's not like chunky glitter on your face. It just gives a pretty subtle glow and like gets your skin primed and ready for a foundation. I mean, you guys be the judge, but does this side of my face look $50 better than this side of my face? Let me know in the comments. All right, up next for complexion, I'm gonna go in with affordable products first for this one. I'm gonna use the e.l.f. Camo CC Cream. If you watch my channel, you know that I absolutely love this product. This honestly could be a dupe for so many different high-end products, and I've used it in many videos in the past. I wanna thank e.l.f. so much for partnering with me on this section of today's video, but again, truly one of my favorite products, I love it. So I'm gonna use shade Light 280 Neutral on the more affordable side. You do not need a lot of this product. It has a very full coverage to it. It has lots of skin-loving ingredients too. It has collagen, peptides, and niacinamide in it, as well as SPF. It's color correcting and gives a beautiful natural finish. So the most common product that I see people dupe this for is the IT Cosmetics CC Cream, which it definitely is a dupe for that. I've actually already tested that in a video and showed you guys that. So today we're going to be putting it up against another high-end product that I think it's a definite dupe for. And I already tested it prior to this video, so it definitely is. But you guys can see this side of my face versus this side, which obviously does not have any complexion products on it yet. This eye looks way more perfected. It can work for all skin types. So whether you have dry skin, oily skin, combo, it's meant to work for all different types of skin. It comes in 20 different shades. I absolutely love it. But the high-end product that I recently tried that I also really liked is from Urban Decay. And this is the Urban Decay Hydromaniac Tinted Glow Hydrator. So it's a very similar product, except it's double the price. This is $29, where the e.l.f. Camo CC Cream is only $14. So it's actually a little bit more than double the price. This one only comes in 12 shades, but it does also have skin-loving ingredients in it. It feels hydrating on the skin while giving you a good coverage. So I'm gonna put them next to each other to show you guys. And I'm using shade Medium 50 in this in my e.l.f. Camo. I was Light 280 Neutral. This one does oxidize a little bit, so hoping shade-wise they will match. The shades are actually looking pretty good on both sides, which is nice. So you guys can see them blended out right next to each other. Very, very similar looking on the face. Like I feel like it doesn't look like I did my face with two different products, but one side is half the price. So absolutely love this. This is, in my opinion, like one of the best drugstore products that have come out in the past year. I use it all the time. Up next for concealer, I'm gonna jump in on the high-end side with the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. This is super, super popular. And this retails for $30. So I'm gonna place this. I have shade Creme Brulee. So I'm going to apply to the under eyes, and I'm also gonna use it to spot conceal some blemishes that I have. This is a medium to buildable. With the amount I use, honestly, it's gonna give you a full coverage. If you just use a little bit of it, it'll give you more of a medium coverage. But I like a more full coverage like look to my under eyes. So that's typically like how much I use. I do really like this product because it gives a good coverage, but it's not drying to your under eyes, which is nice. But again, of course, does come with a $30 price tag. So you guys know I got you on the dupe. A great dupe is the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer. This is $6 and works very similarly. The shade I have in this is Fair Beige. So I'm gonna apply this to the under eyes. This you actually need a little bit less of because it is a true full coverage concealer. They have the regular camo as well, which is very nice. This one is the more hydrating version, which I find to be very similar to the NARS concealer. So I'm just gonna blend that out. And I also did wanna let you guys know that when e.l.f. reached out to me about today's video, they were like, you know, you can pick up to $100 worth of products on our website and we'll send it to you to use for the video. And I was like, girl, I already got all your products because I use all their products all the time. So I already have them, I have them stocked. So I was like, can I do a giveaway for my subscribers instead? And they were like, yes, absolutely. So just comment down below like one fun activity you wanna do for the fall, whether it be like pumpkin picking or apple picking or just getting a pumpkin spice latte, like anything like that, just comment that down below and a way for me to get in contact with you. And I'll just randomly pick one of you guys and you can pick up to $100 worth of products from e.l.f.'s website for you to have and to try. So just comment that down below if you're interested. All right, so I feel like our face is looking quite similar side to side. We are gonna jump in now to cream blush. So on the high end side, I have the Fenty Cream Blush in the shade Strawberry Drip, if I can open it. This is a really pretty pink shade and it retails for $20. So I'm gonna go in and apply to my cheeks. The Fenty Cream Blushes are kind of like almost balmy in consistency. They look almost scary in the pan because they're so bright, but then once you apply them, they're definitely more muted and just blend really nicely into the skin. But I found a drugstore option that works super similarly, and that is the Flower Gel Crush Cheek and Lip. This one specifically in the shade Blackberry Crush. Looks almost identical on, and they're the same kind of balmy consistency. So this one technically you're supposed to just go like this on your face, but I don't like to do that. I like to apply with a brush better. And I just kind of go like this with it and tap on the cheeks. And this one retails for about $8.99, so it's a little bit less than half the price of the Fenty one. And actually when first applied, a little bit more pigmented, like they're the same color and tone, but this side is brighter, but you can sheer it out and kind of morph it into the skin and they look pretty much the same. I'll normally just pop over it with my beauty blender, no extra product or anything, but just to kind of sheer it out, and really can't tell much of a difference once applied to the face. Up next for setting powder, we're gonna go in with the Kosas Cloud Set on the high end side. This is a nice powder because it's super lightweight. It feels like nothing on the skin, but it will set your makeup in and lock it in all day. So I'm just gonna go over my face with this. This does retail for $34 and I do like the lightweight feel that it has, but of course, you guys know I got a drugstore option for you. So the drugstore option that works very similarly is the Physician's Formula Natural Defense Finishing Powder. So finishing powders in general are lighter than like a setting powder would be. And this one works pretty much exactly the same. It sets your makeup in, but it feels very light on the face. Isn't gonna make you dry or cakey. It's just gonna help to set everything down and maximize wear throughout the day. And this retails for about $11. You can get it on Amazon. This one does have a slight scent to it. It's not crazy, where the Kosas one is unscented. So just something to note. All right, now we're gonna jump into brows. On the high end side, I'm gonna use the Benefit Precisely My Brow. This retails for $24. I'm using this in shade 2 today. Has a spoolie on one side to kind of get your brows in place and then a little pencil on the other. I like precise little pencils like this personally. So this is one of my high end favorites as far as like brow pencils go, because it's really easy to get in and precisely fill in your brows. That's why it's called, you know, Precisely My Brow. But a very similar product is the Joa Precision Brow. So this is normally about $8. I have this in shade Warm Medium Brown. Same sort of concept, spoolie on one side, tiny precise little pencil. I mean, even the names are similar on these and they work very similarly on the brow. So I'm gonna go in and fill this brow in on the affordable side. The shades on these are slightly different. You'll see once I'm done filling in. The Joa one has a little bit more warmth to it, which I actually personally like for my brows, but not a super big difference in shade and is easy to use to just fill in the brows quickly and keep it moving. All right, brows are done. Now we're gonna jump into eyeshadow. I am so excited about this dupe. So for the high-end side, I have the Huda Beauty New Nude Palette. This retails for $65. It's a very pretty palette, but I recently found on Amazon a palette that I really like. It's from the brand Novo. It was literally $8. Amazon sometimes can like change their pricing day to day, but when I purchased it, it was $8, and it is nearly identical to the Huda palette. So I've used this before, and I bought it for like a testing Amazon makeup video. I'm gonna put the palettes next to each other so you guys can see. Super, super similar. But when I bought the Amazon palette, I expected it to work like an $8 palette from Amazon. Like I was hoping that it was good, but I didn't think that it was gonna be like great, and it actually worked so beautifully. The shadows were pigmented, they worked really well, so I'm really excited to actually put it up against the Huda palette, like eye to eye, and see if we can actually create the same look and see the differences, because obviously it's a huge difference in price. We're gonna jump in on the high end side first. We'll go in with the Huda palette and go in with the shade Secret. And I'm gonna go in and buff this in the crease. And I will use different eye brushes on each eye just so we don't cross-contaminate any of the colors. Then gonna go in the same shade in the Amazon palette on the other eye and buff this in the crease. Looks super similar. You can see with the Amazon, it's a little bit more purpley, where the one in the Huda palette's a little bit more pink. Overall, I think once the full eye look is done, we're not really gonna be able to tell much of a difference, but we'll see. Next in the Huda palette, gonna go in with the shade Tease and pop that right on top to begin to deepen up the crease. Pretty like mauvey purple shade. And same shade in the Amazon palette. Buffing that into the crease as well on the other side. I always get so scared I'm gonna mix up the sides, but we're not gonna do that. Not speaking that into existence, not today. Honestly, I feel like the Amazon palette like even blends easier. Like I really was surprised by how good this palette was. I do find this shade again also to be a little bit darker, but I'm like, it might even just be that this shadow itself is more pigmented, but I'm gonna go in with a fluffy blending brush and just kind of buff it, but it does show up a little bit darker on the eye. Next, I'm gonna jump in with the shade Raw in the Huda palette, and I'm gonna buff this in the outer crease and that little outer V area. And same shade in the Amazon palette. I'm like trying to not get them mixed up on the other eye. I'm gonna place it in the same area, that outer crease, and just buffing that in. All right, here's where I feel we may see a big difference. So I'm going with the Huda palette on the high end side. I'm gonna go in with the shade Daydream, which is a pretty shimmer. Looks like this. I feel like the Huda shimmers will probably be better. Oh, I thought I was going on the wrong side. I'm like, no, this is right, but we'll see. So I'm gonna tap this on my lid with my finger. This is a pretty shimmer, and it's also like a duochrome kind of shade, so it's very pretty. Then on the other eye, jumping into the Amazon palette and also the same shade Daydream. Also using my finger for this and tapping it on. Oh wow, actually pretty similar. The color looks pretty much the same. Jumping back into the Huda side, we're gonna go in with the shade Love Bite, and I'm just using a small angled brush to apply this to my lower lash line. Same thing on the other side, but now with the Amazon palette. Honestly, every shadow in the Amazon palette is just a little bit darker and more pigmented. Like, I feel like looking at them next to each other, I like the way the Amazon side looks better than I do the Huda side. This side is a little bit more purpley, where the Huda's a little bit more pink, but I feel like overall this side looks more vibrant. Like, I like the way it looks better. Then to blend it out, I'm gonna jump in with Kinky from the Huda palette. This is like a shimmer. And I'm gonna buff out the lower lash line. Same thing on the other side with the Amazon palette, buffing out that lower lash line. Then for highlight on the high-end side, I'm gonna mix together Bare and Crave. I'm gonna mix both of those shades together, and I'm gonna pop those in the inner corner and beneath the brow bone. Then I'm gonna mix together those same shades on the Amazon side and pop them in the same place. This is actually the first shade that I think the Huda side is more vibrant. Like I feel like the pop of the highlight on the Huda side is more vibrant than the pop of the highlight on this side. But overall, I feel like this palette is really, really good. The eyes don't look exactly identical. The Amazon side's a bit darker and a bit more purple, where the Huda is a little bit more pinky. But I honestly like the way that the Amazon eye looks better. And overall, I don't think there's a like $60 difference in between each eye. So let me know which side you guys like. Do you like the Amazon side better, or do you prefer the Huda? I would love to hear your thoughts. For eyeliner on the high end side, I'm gonna go in with the Kylie. I actually really like this eyeliner pencil from Kylie Cosmetics. It retails for $18, and it's very pigmented and easy to use. So I'm gonna just line my upper lash line, and I'm gonna do a wing as well. Because this has a really precise tip, it does make it really easy to do a wing, which is one of my favorite aspects of this. But you know I got you on a more affordable version. But this is really, really nice. I know she just, like they still have this, but she reformulated her product, so I hope it's as good. Because I haven't tried the new one, and this one is very nice. But for the dupe side, this Koki retractable liner, this is $6 and so, so good. Very similar, as it's a precise little tip, but it's longer, so it's easy to use and easy to make a wing with. And this is also very pigmented. So also gonna do a little wing with this one. doing my winged liner is like the one time that I like can't talk while I'm doing it. Overall for this, I will say I like the Kai liner better, but I think the Koki one is very similar. All right, now for our mascara. On the high end side, we have the IT Cosmetics Superhero Mascara. I actually really like this. This retails for $25 and it's a volumizing and lengthening mascara. So I'm gonna go in on my lashes with this and I'm gonna do a good two coats. All right, now on the more affordable side, we're gonna go in with the Essence Lash Princess Volume Mascara. So I've never actually put these two against each other, but they are apparently a dupe. So we're gonna see, wands look quite different. A lot of people love the Essence Lash Paradise. This is a fan favorite for sure. I was never crazy about them. I think I tried the one in the purple packaging, if I remember correctly, and never was like crazy about it, but I'm interested to see how these look next to each other. So I'm also gonna do two coats of this. Okay, I will say, I stand corrected. These do actually work very similarly to each other. Like, I feel like my lashes both look volumized and lengthened on both sides. So this did work pretty well. I am gonna put mascara on my lower lashes, but I wanna do my tightline liner first. Or not tightline, waterline liner. So on the high end side, I'm gonna jump in with the Makeup Forever Aqua Resist. This is just the shade black. This retails for $22 and is very pigmented. So pop that on the waterline. And then on the more affordable side, I'm gonna go in with the e.l.f. This is the waterproof gel eyeliner, also in the shade black. This retails for $4 and is also super pigmented and works really, really nicely. And then I will go in on the respected sides and just do my little lower mascara. All right, now we're gonna jump back into the face and finish up. So on the high end side, we're gonna be going in with the Too Faced Bare It All Bronzer. I love this bronzer, it's really pretty. It gives like a pretty shimmery, like all over glow to the face. And this retails for $32. It smells so good. So I'm going in on the high end side with this, just to bronze up the skin. And then on the drugstore side, I'm gonna jump in with a newer product. This is from Physicians Formula, and this is the Butter Cake Bronzer. Looks very similar. And also smells so good. They have different scents, but they both smell delicious. So I'm gonna go in with this on the drugstore side to bronze it up. They both give like a pretty shimmery glow to the skin. Up next for highlight on the high end side, we're gonna go in with the Milk Blitzed Highlighter. This is really, really pretty. It's like a gold that also has like a lot of pink kind of pigments in it. I really like this. This retails for $28. So I'm gonna top it on my cheeks. Ooh, so pretty. It definitely has a lot of shimmer in it, so if you don't like blinding, like really shimmery highlights, this isn't gonna be for you, but I do like this. Normally I would put highlight down my nose, but because we're kind of doing the half and half, it doesn't really work, so I'm just gonna leave it on the cheek. But on the affordable side, we have the Wet n Wild Precious Petals Highlighter, which this has been one of my favorites for such a long time. These are normally about $4. I love Wet n Wild's highlights, they're so good, so I'm gonna put it on this side and show you guys how similar they are. And I'm gonna just pop that on this cheek, and so, so pretty too, but you guys can see this is the Wet n Wild versus the Milk. Super, super similar. Both blinding, both beautiful, love them. All right, I'm just cleaning off my lips before we go in with our last little lip product. So on the high end side, I'm gonna be going in with one of my favorites. This is the Tarte Maracuja Juicy Lips. I really, really like these because they're like a lipstick lip gloss in one. So I'm gonna use the shade Raspberry today. These are normally $19 and I'm going to apply to the high end side. Like, they go on like a lipstick, but they have a really pretty glossy finish. So I like these a lot, but Wet n Wild came out with something very similar. It's like the same concept. These are their High Shine Brilliance lipsticks. So they're basically lipsticks that are super shiny, like with a lip gloss like finish. And this one is in the shade Jam With Me. And it's very similar in how they work. So I'm just putting this on the more affordable side. And these are normally like $2.99. So the Wet n Wild one is slightly darker, and I will say the Tarte ones last better. Because they're a super shiny, glossy finish, neither last for a really long time. I do think the Tarte Maracuja Juicy ones do last longer. The Wet n Wild ones do tend to slip off a bit faster, but overall very similar in color, similar in finish. So if you're just looking for something that's like the same type of color, the Wet n Wild is obviously way more affordable price, so you can't go wrong with that. So that is everything for the initial side-by-side. I feel like we look pretty similar. Like, I have to go out in public and stuff, so obviously I'm not gonna be taking this off because we're gonna do the wear test and see how everything wears, and I feel like it doesn't look blatantly obvious that I did two sides of my face with two completely different sets of products. So I'm gonna wear this on my skin for at least 6 hours, which I'm just realizing now that that means I'm gonna have to work out with this on, which I don't love, but for you guys, I'm gonna do it. And I will check in with you guys later tonight before I wash my face and stuff and go to bed and show you guys a wear test. I'll probably even end up wearing it for more than 6 hours and just wear it throughout the rest of the day. The lips are definitely not gonna stay on because I still have to eat lunch and dinner. dinner and stuff, but we'll be able to see how the rest of the makeup wears. So I will see you guys in a little bit. What's up, you guys? I am back for my final check-in, looking all crusty. Home from the gym, I'm ready to shower, but I wanted to show you guys final check-in of how this makeup wore. I tried to not like do super intense workouts that were gonna make me sweat like crazy because that would just be a disaster. But overall, I feel like both sides held up very well. It is almost 8:30 now. So I had it on for like almost 8 hours at this point, that is. To remind you guys again, this is the affordable dupe side. This is the high-end side. I honestly think both sides held up very well throughout the day. My brows, you can see, look a little crazy. They're like all out of whack. I haven't touched anything up, so I feel like it still looks really good on both sides, but obviously the more affordable side is more impressive because all the products were at a much cheaper price point, and I feel like they held up just as well as the high-end products did. I don't see like a huge change in either side of my face. I mean, you guys let me know down below what you guys think, but I'll kind of pan side to side. I feel like they held up really well, so I wanted to include this in the end because I've done these dupe videos in the past where people always ask to see like a wear test of how the products wear throughout the day, and I feel like they held up against each other very well. So I'll have all the products that I use down below in the description box. Check there if you guys want to check anything out. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you so much, and I'll see you very soon in my next video. Bye.